got big deals, big money in the NFL this week.
Big
man.
Money!
I like it! So, your boy Winfield, man, from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 4 year, $84.1 million. Highest paid defensive back in NFL history. But then also your boy Jared Goff.
Jared Goff.
4 years, $212 million, $170 million guaranteed. Number one overall pick is the highest paid Lion in franchise history. Passing out them dead presidents.
It's well deserved, though.
For sure.
Listen, Detroit, y'all get my blessing. Not that y'all cared anyway, but I'm going to let y'all motherfuckers know something anyway. Because this is why I respect Jared Goff. Because I've said it many times. Even when I called him a game manager. Okay?
Which is not a bad thing.
It is not a bad connotation to
style of play
that person is. Okay? He went. He was shipped. He was migrated to Detroit to die.
Mm-hmm.
Respectfully.
They threw him to the pack, came back leading it.
Came back leading the pride. You dig what I'm saying? What he's been able to do in Detroit is something that no quarterback has ever been able to do. And I say that respectfully. So, yeah, man, well-deserved.
So he's definitely worth the bag.
Yes.
He's worth the bag.
Yes. Yeah, for sure, for shit show. Like.
So from a player perspective, question for you. When you sign a big deal like this, is it more pressure on you to perform? Like, because you got to, like, live. No, is really. That running through your mind?
No, this is third contract, right?
Yeah. But this is his biggest contract, though.
Of course.
So, like, even in his mind, or even when you signed a bigger contract.
Nothing
like,
should change.
Nothing.
I think he's proved to the locker room, to the executive and the fans that this is who he is. Mm-hmm. What more does he have to do?
Yeah.
He's been in Detroit going on 3 years now.
I want to say so, yeah.
3 or 4 years. But he's proven himself to be the reliable player that they can depend on.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, that's something that it's no surprise, bro. And that's just how it goes. It's like the next person up is going to topple that. You know what I mean? It is what it is.
So, Cam, man, there's some other quarterbacks up to get that type of money. You got Trevor Lawrence, Dak Prescott, Jordan Love, and Tua. Tua is expected to sign a $200 million deal. Do you think he will get this type of money? Yes or no, and why?
Yes.
Why so?
It's just what the market says.
That's what it is?
Trevor Lawrence, yes.
Dak?
I don't think Dak wants that.
That what? That pressure or just to be in Dallas that long?
It's a little bit of both. Like, I don't know if Dak wants it or even Jerry Jones wants to give Dak another opportunity. Because it's been showtime. Like, you done showed us what you... Like, the game has changed in regards to development. We're not developing talent no more. It's... Damn sure, like, you up to the plate. What can you do? We don't have time to keep waiting on what you gonna do and what you... So that's what I say about Dak. I mean, I think Dak is a top-tier talent. He has capabilities, you know, to manage the game at a high level. But I think his time in Dallas is dwindling right before our eyes. And it's either between Dak wanting to be there or Jerry Jones wanting Dak there. That's the real question. Tua, on the other hand, I just think that's what the market dictates. But damn, that motherfucker was dealt some spades.
I mean, he got a handful.
What?
Yes, sudden, boom, Odell.
Waddle.
Waddle.
Cheetah.
Pop.
He got motherfuckers that can pop the top off.
And
if I'm telling you, the most excited person in that huddle is Odell. Because now Odell don't have to be... He's going to a team that's a hybrid offense, meaning they're going to attack you in so many different ways. Now Odell can really show his full skillfulness as a receiver.
Yeah.
And it's a perfect match, man. Oh, my goodness. I mean, if that don't work, I don't know, man. His skill set has always been a pristine possession receiver. Now, he's been a superstar receiver, but... His catching ability has always been his skill set.
Yeah.
Route running, those things. He hasn't been able to really, like...
Open up.
show downfield threatening. I mean, obviously, after you tear your ACL, you know, that Cleveland Odell was the last Odell from stretching vertical. Mm-hmm. Now, can he? Yes. But Odell's success comes now intermediate in possession. He knows that. So I'm excited to see Miami Dolphins. That's one of those. That's one of those cheat teams. Madden going to get ready. Like,
he got
hey.
Them spades in his hand, boy. He got, you he called got it
the,
right there.
He got the ace of spades.
Smacking him on the table.
He got the queen, and he got a good ten of spades that's like, it's going to walk.
Woo! What did all that say? I'm going to take it around down. So take it around town, do some shopping around.
Yeah, huh? Shopping around. I'm a dog walk your ass. Yeah.
Come on out there.
It's time for me to go downtown and do a little shopping around right by now. Come on out, everyone.